Hello and welcome back to Tharic Plays Blood Bowl 2. We are going to play with our orcs today, and what match are we at, by the way, now? It's 36, okay. So still some ways to go. This is the team as it's in its current state. Don't think we got any level ups last time, did we? What was the last match? I don't quite remember. Okay, yeah, we've got the win against some dwarves here. I did already have the tackle on Orc City, I believe. Yeah, I don't think we got a level up last time. But we're close on some of them, especially on these three black orcs. I'd be very happy to get some there. But let's just try to find an opponent, shall we? Okay, 58 seconds. See you in a moment, I guess. And here we go. For 1540 chaos. Could be good, could be bad. It depends. We do have the skill advantage, but he's got some mean players. That could be an issue. Three rerolls is fine. He's got a mighty blow claw. Chaos Warrior, he's got a mighty blow claw piling on. Tackle. Move busted. Maybe niggling? Nope, just move busted. Beastman, this guy is gonna be my number one priority. And not much else besides that, but he's got a good record, at least a fairly decent record, so we'll see what we can do here. And the team is called Clawy McClawface, so anybody want to guess what he's going to go for? We'll see what I can do. It could be fine. And since these are a bit delayed in terms of when they come out, Wizard is expected. This is the first video I've recorded, I think, since the Chaos Dwarfs and Khemri release. So from now on out, we might be able to see one of those teams. And the Blood Bowl 2 Legendary Edition announcement has, of course, also happened. And I'm looking forward to some of the teams that are going to be released with that. Primarily three, I think. Oh boy. So how many players did he have? Let me check that again real quick. Just 10, so he has a loner, no bench. Could be fine. And he went with a wizard, a bribe, and a babe. So the three teams I'm looking forward to most out of the legendary update are pro-elves, because they're still my favorite elf team. That's the reason why my avatar is the elf avatar in this game. Underworld, because mutating Skaven and Goblins are fun. It's a cool team to play, I think. And last but not least, Kislev, which are reskinned and a little bit tweaked, I think, Slan. So they're a weird team. They've got Leap on basically everything and very long legs as well, the mutation to make that Leap better. They're an odd team, that's for sure, but I like their general idea, so I'm looking forward to playing them as well. Nope, there we go. And our opponent's name is Stick, and he's playing, as I've already pointed out, Clawy McClawface. And this team has three scary players, and that's about it. Those three players could be enough, though. And out of those, only two are very dangerous to our personal health. The last one is more of a, if he ever gets this guy next to our ball carrier, I'm going to be annoyed. Strong, I don't know. Because he's got agility 4, he can move around fairly easily, he's got tackle, block, dodge, and diving tackle. Yeah, that's just annoying to deal with. Probably no big surprise there that I don't necessarily like that. And now I have to decide who to keep off the pitch. And I think I'm gonna actually bring my dirty player here. We're on offense. I'd like to make as much use of that as I can. I probably won't be able to really foul on the first turn here, but that's okay. And all I really want is some good blocks here early on. So let's see what we can make happen there. So get all of this in order. Let's see, is this fine? This is my mighty blow block over to here. No, he's gonna block over to this side. These two need to switch, I think. So we're gonna block here. Then we're gonna block here. And then the frenzy guy can move in. Okay. Seems okay enough. Although I should probably do this. Because if I only push, I don't want to follow. Or if we knock down, it's a thing. It makes sense in my head. Yeah, this is fine. Let's see what will happen. So, it's at least a nice thing to say. So he's got to try and refrain from swearing when I pile on his poor line of scrimmage. I mean, he's playing Chaos. He has to live with that. We're gonna stay. Ooh, let's see what we get. So into a stun on the first one. I really hope that I can get a player advantage early on here. That would be the preferred outcome for me. I'm just gonna take the both down right here. I should not have done that, actually. Because of the frenzy block. So I'll have to do this now to make sure that everything's okay. There we go. So actually very harmless first move into this. And where do we want to blitz? So we'll probably want to do this and blitz right here. He could get my guy, but if that happens, it happens. Not much I can do about it. We're gonna stay. There we go. Come on. Another stun. Okay. Not quite what I was hoping for, but it's an okay enough start, I think. So we'll take it. He could fireball me right away now. I don't think that's necessarily gonna happen, but he could if he wanted to. Do I really want to give him this one, though? I think we're gonna do this, as weird as it might look. Move him back to here. And let's see if I can make that pickup work. We can with the reroll. There we go. Okay. And at least for the Blood Bowl videos on YouTube here, this is probably also new. I should be a bit louder than usual because I have my microphone closer to my mouth than I used to. I usually went for a little bit more of a distance, but I've since then discovered that apparently it's better to have it close. I really should have known this already. And it's not, I don't think it's that big of a difference, but a little bit at least. And so I like to get the most out of this if possible. So I'm just pointing it out. Yeah, he's gonna blitz this guy. I was considering taking the GFI and bringing him back here, but in the end I didn't really want to risk the extra block. Or the extra roll. Now I might pay for that. Maybe. There we go. Okay, into the stun. Back. That is okay. But that's Basically, my armor value 9 is meaningless against his blitzes, because he's always gonna blitz with his Mighty Blow guys, if at all possible. And he's also trying his best to protect them as much as possible. There's no way I can blitz this guy. He's got guard here, he's got guard there, and he's strength 4, so I'm just not gonna get a good block there. And he moves this guy back into protection after blitzing, which is the right thing to do. And then he's also trying to screen as much as possible, which certainly helps. And he did not stand up any of these guys, which might also be the right call to make. Ultimately. I'm considering how big we want to go in this. I think I might be persuaded to go in fairly deep. Also considering if I should foul, it's probably not worth it against an unskilled lineman. It could be awesome, but I don't think so. So let's count this out. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Into a GFI blitz. I think I'm actually okay with that. It's a bit of a risk, but it's not too bad. Let's bring him up this way as well. We really just need to cover those bases. Like so. So he can't. I want him to end his turn there. But that won't happen yet, so these two guys need to stay there for now. And then we'll go for the blitz. And that worked. So I do get the knockdown. I think I'm gonna keep push him up there just to keep him next to the Black Orc. I did not get through the armor. I will not pile on. It's not worth it. It's too risky. And that's pretty much the entire reason. So do I want to foul this? It's not a good foul, and the double could happen, so we're just gonna do this. And try to make this safe. He might fireball me again. I cannot forget about the fireball. I don't think it's gonna happen. Because I've got basically two layers of defense here. One with the cage itself, and one with these guys screening everything. But yeah, he's gonna go after my killer now, with his killer. That was expected. Which is why I was considering to actually pile on, but he also has a bribe. And he might be in the market to foul me. Oh, he's actually going for the piling on. Okay. Didn't get through. So this is my best chance to get a foul on his killer. He's gonna try and use guard to make that as unlikely as possible, but we'll see if he can pull it through. I think he needs to stand up these guys because he doesn't want these to move. So that's kind of what needs to happen. I can potentially still free up my dirty player here. All we need is block this guy away and then block this guy away. And then he pushes, nothing more. Yep, he's bringing in another guard player here. I don't think I will be able to make this work. It's at least unlikely. There is some stuff we can do, but I'll have to wait and see. That knockdown makes things difficult. I'm gonna stand firm. Okay. He did not stand them up, which is interesting. So this is a two-dice blitz. Which I'm gonna do. Thank you so much. I think we're gonna push him down here and I'm gonna follow. Once again, did not get through the armor, so I'm not gonna pile on. Then we can block him. I'm okay with rerolling this one. It's important to knock him down. Put him over there and follow. And now I can foul him with two assists. So we are gonna do that, I think. Still need to keep my ball carrier safe as much as possible. So let's see about the defense. You can get all the way up to here. That's fine. Once again, the fireball is a potential issue with this. So let's bring him to there. I'm okay with having him right there. Just need to cover this. How do we do that? We probably want him right there. He still needs to stand up. I think we're just gonna do this. And now I'm gonna foul. 58 with 30 player. Let's see what happens. Got through. It's a stun at least. It's a start. Won't be using this guy. Would have liked an injury. I assume he would have appled that. But still, depending on the injury, he might not have come back. And this guy is definitely our biggest danger. But since he's still unwilling to use the wizard right now, we are looking good, I think. I've got my guard in place in the important places. He will be able to two-dice me here. This guy will get a two-dice blitz. There we go. Nothing, though. Will he reroll? He's thinking about it. He is, and he gets the knockdown. Okay, let's see what will happen and how he's gonna push. He might try to chain push. Yeah, okay, but basically I thought he might chain push up here to put himself into a position where he can get a two dice right there, which could have worked. He went a different route, so he needs one more assist to make this a two dice. So I'd love to score with somebody else, of course, but I'm not sure that'll happen, to be honest. It's not very likely right now. He went for that. I'm actually okay with that. Ooh, he's taking some risks with his dodges here. If he makes that one, it's a good one though. Oh, with the foul. Maybe. Nope, he's not gonna go for the foul. Well, that worked. Okay, let's think about these. I could free up him, but I think I just like to take this block into some pushes. Well, isn't that unfortunate? He certainly is not making this easy for me. So let's think about these. I still really want to foul this guy again. If I get the chance. I'm just trying to figure out how to blitz here. We could do this one, which would, with Dauntless, would be a two dice, but I also need to remember that I need to protect him. But I do have an idea for that. So I probably need to try and see if I can make it work. So we'll do this. No, that's GFI. Yeah, we'll need to do this blitz. If that doesn't work, I'm kind of screwed. Does though. Okay, very nice. Then we can bring him through there. Looks weird and plays weird, but I think ultimately should be okay for the most part. I think we want to be right there. Oh, he's gonna fireball me now. I can smell it. It's the risk we're taking, but that's okay. And now I can foul him again. And I think I'm gonna keep him down here. So there we go. Got through. Into the injury. No doubles either. Badly hurt, he's gonna apo that. And that means the guy's just gonna come back. But at least for now, he's out. And that's an important start. And his apothecary is gone. Which means every other injury will stick in case we get more. He might decide to fireball me now, but I don't really think he can get away with a ball afterwards once again, so he's not doing that. Gets a knockdown against Warrior, that was expected. Okay. At least his claw is not really doing much right now. And this puts me in a position where I can get my piling on block going. So he might want to try and remove this guy. Maybe. So this is a two dice against. Yeah, even if he stands up this guy, it's a one dice. So we're not really through yet. As you might expect, but we're getting there. At least now we have a one-player advantage. And, oh, yeah, okay, well, no, that's fine. Especially if that happens. So is he gonna reroll that? He is into a knockdown. That's okay, though. Let's see what we'll get. Okay, now he's got a ball, now he's got a player next to me. And he's going pretty much all in with his moves. Risks the dodge even to give himself a two dice right here. Which only pushes, I assume, to up there. There we go. Yeah, that's fine. So what we're gonna do is bring him down to here. Next, I'm gonna take this block. That's the important claw guy. Did not get through the armor once again. I'm considering piling on there now. But I don't think it's worth it. There's still some issues with this right now, though, that I need to clear up. Because, okay, we need to block him. I need to see if that block works on top of everything. Either way, we'll bring Warrior in here. And I'll guess we'll bring Wall up to there. I would have liked to foul, but I don't really think it's worth it. Okay, let's do this one. Need to reroll. That one's fairly crucial. Oh, into a stun. Okay. The important bit about that one was... Oh, well, I actually screwed myself a little bit here, I think. Overall. Because if I now only push here... I will not be able to get away. And I can't really dodge. Can I... We cannot do that, so yeah, we need to do this and just hope that it works. Okay, it does. Put him down there and follow. Okay, now move through. We probably want to block like this first. I've got Frenzy, so that's fine. Let's try that again. Into this. Well, that's not necessarily what I wanted to see. But I think it could be worse. Could potentially move him there? No. Okay, now these become weird, for the most part. I'm okay with doing this one dice, I think, because it's a 1 in 6 chance to actually screw it up, which we don't, and I'm gonna stay. Oh, come on. There we go, it's KO. He does have one babe, though. Now I have one move left, both of which would be bad blocks, so I'm not gonna risk a dodge, and we'll just take the end of the turn. Oh, so I have 3 turns left to score. And I think right now we're once again back into a pretty good position. He's mostly shut out on this side. He can't reach me. He has some blocks, but not too many. He might decide to foul me now, because he does have a bribe. Is that gonna work? I would love to score with a black orc, but I still don't think we're in a position where I can really afford to try and hand off the ball. It's just not secure enough with everything that's going on, even though we do have a player advantage. I'm not a fan. Okay, he's chain pushing himself with that move. Didn't get the knockdown, though. That's important. At least I assume that's what he's aiming for. Yep, putting himself in the way of things. But he might have actually done me a favor with that, because if I want, I can now serve this guy. And I think that might actually be not the worst idea ever. Alternatively, I could actually serve this guy, which would be way better. For that, yeah, that does. It's doable. Especially with his dodge, it's doable. If he does that, it gets a lot harder. He doesn't, though. So I've got two serve options here, but I think I'm going to go with a Beastman, even though the Strength 4 guy would be awesome to get away. This guy worries me more. Oh, there we go. Got a KO on Awakening. That's a bummer. I mean, he might decide to go for... he might decide to go for a Lightning Bolt as a last action, and that could screw me over. But I don't think he will. Okay, he dodges him out, which actually makes my surfing idea a lot easier. I want my stand firm there, though. I'd love to foul, but I don't think we can really swing that. Well, I can't go with that guy either, so I need to do this. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, now this is the risky part, because I'm doing this and leaving myself open in case I fail. But I kind of needed the movement first. There we go, so this guy's off the pitch. Nothing happens to him, though. Which is a shame, then I can move back one space, so at least I'm safe from being surfed right now. And we'll move... Wasted through to there. So covering all that is actually not a guarantee right now. I'm gonna try and make it happen in the best possible way, which means we need to do this block, which works. Gonna push him to there and follow, because I'm still hoping for a pile-on option. Nope. But this allows me to now bring him... where do we actually want to put him? Right there. And I can bring Orchiginal up this way. And that leaves me with one block. And I'll go for the Beastman, just because he doesn't have block. Good choice. And there we go. I think I have a good control over everything right now, which helps a lot. Oh, there goes the fireball, knocks down the ball carrier. And that's it. Oh, we got lucky there. That could have been way worse. I still need to pick it up again, but I've got two turns to do so. So I might even be inclined to do the dumb stuff and try it with Award Winner or what you're looking at. At least for one turn. We could screw ourselves out of a touchdown with that, but I have two rerolls left. And I'm willing to use them to try and make that pickup. But he's also going to try and put... a ball carrier on, or put pressure on there, maybe even try and go for the weird pickup, which could work. So we're probably just looking at making of the pickup with the thrower. It's our best bet, but he's still gonna try and bring as many players on there as possible. So one's gonna go here. And that will make it difficult for me. No, he's going in full body. Shouldn't do that. Arguably, over here would make it more difficult for me. There we go. He's still trying to decide. So what's he going with? Did not bring this guy next to the ball, which makes it easier for me again to actually do something. So I like that. Let's see, he makes his dodge and the GFI. With the guard, that gives him a 2-dice block right there, which is a turnover if he doesn't reroll it, which he does. So now he makes it. Good block, but it cost him his last reroll, and now he can't reroll that. Okay. So this is doable, obviously. Let's just stand up our players first, that I'm not really gonna use. So this is a 1-dice. Need to make that into a 2-dice. So we'll do this. And all I need here is a push. Also don't get anything better. So there's that. I'm gonna follow. So I'm trying to decide what to do here. I think I should blitz like this, just push him down. It's once again the 2-dice against the dangerous player. And we just want to push him out of reach. Oh, got through the armor. So now I'm gonna pile on, because that's only a stun. Come on, give me something better. Nope. That's okay, though. He's still stunned. And there's no danger coming from this side, I think. We'll bring him to right there. He's gonna stay there. And now I'm gonna attempt another pickup. Which works. Good. This could come. So we'll bring Wasabi to right there and leave it at that. So we'll leave the first half with me in the lead. In all likelihood, there's a small chance that I'm gonna screw that up. Or that he actually gets to do something. Oh, he's doing an unassisted foul on my piling on guy, which did nothing. That's okay. So pretty much the only way for me to screw this still up is if I roll... that's good enough. Is if I roll double skulls somewhere. He could still blitz me, which is what he's going for right now. But he needs double pows, which he doesn't get. So he's just gonna force me to score, because it's the only thing that can happen here. And I don't get my turn 8, which is fine. Let's see if his KO comes back. Chances are he's gonna be able to field a full team again. Yep, and my KO stayed out, is that correct? Did I skip that accidentally? Yes, he stays out for now. So that's a bummer. And he's gonna foul. That's out of the question. The only big question is... What do we give him? Probably still the dirty player. And this lineman. And probably this lineman, unfortunately. They are the least valuable ones in this scenario. And so he's gonna do his thing there. Ideally, he's just not gonna be able to knock all of them down. He is out of rerolls. Yeah, definitely could have been worse. I mean, the fireball was pretty meaningless. But nothing too bad happened to both teams so far. Just 1k on my side. He's out of his apo. I didn't quite get what I wanted. I got my early window to try and make something good happen, and it didn't really work out. It's nothing he can do there. I still think my conservative views of piling on was the right choice. But he's gonna try and make things worse for me now. So this could still turn around completely. It's not out of the question. He's getting 3 free blocks plus blitzes now. Or plus blitz now. And then he's gonna get the same in the next turn. Or on the next turn already again. Because it's his drive then. So there's some real danger here for me right now. Not much I can do about that. But he's keeping his claw guys away, surprisingly enough. I would have assumed he would block with both of them to try and maximize his chances. Or he's actually trying to go for a one-turn touchdown. That's what this looks like right now. Ballsy play without a reroll and with just movement 6. Very ballsy, but let's see if he can pull that off. Yeah, he's gonna blitz right here, chain push himself to there and keep going. I'm interested to see if he can actually pull that off. Okay, that blitz is literally meaningless. Only pushing me. If he can pull that off, I'm gonna be impressed. It's not easy to one turn with movement 6. I don't know how to do it. He's got his entire team, which is, I think, almost necessary here. But that kills it now, I think. Maybe. I don't know. He's got 2 other players. Not sure if he can... if he needs this one. I think he still needed this one to really make it work. Yep, so he's just knocking him down. Right there. And now the killing will commence, apparently. Okay, one more. Got that one as well, so he doesn't even need to blitz. With one of his killers. At least he didn't kill anything. He might still decide to foul. He still has his bribe. I think he'll definitely foul my guard dirty player here. Probably before he attempts a pass. And he's going to use the loner to foul, as you do. So one more player right here. And then he can step on him. Ideally, he's going to roll a double. And nothing major is going to happen. In worst case scenario, he's going to kill him and... he's not even gonna get caught, but we'll see what will happen. Got through. Into a KO. What's the armor roll? No double, so he didn't get caught. I'm still gonna be able to field 11 players, because I've got my bench, but I'd like to get both of them back, obviously. But we'll see, we'll see. That work. Okay, one of them comes back. My dirty player stays out. Which is okay. Not what I wanted, But it could have been worse. At least I have my blitzer back. Yep. Right player is off the pitch. Okay, now this... Oh, my opponent disconnected. I don't think that's on purpose. I assume there's an ISP reset somewhere. Maybe. And I can't really do anything. So, while we wait, at least before I pause this, until he comes back, big question is, who do I want to put on the line of scrimmage here? It's not going to be the thrower, so it needs to be one of my blitzers. And in that case, I think the blitzer to go for is Wasabi. He's just the least valuable in some areas. The strip ball dauntless here is just too important. Agility 4 is also... I might need to use him to reposition and get a good blitz somewhere. And I obviously don't want my piling on guy here. So it's Wasabi by default, basically, as the weak link. But now I'm just gonna pause and wait until he comes back. So, yeah, let's hope that happens soon and see you in a bit. Okay, and we're back. So he came back. And as I've said, Wasabi by default is the guy to put on the line here, unfortunately. And afterwards, I think I'm gonna go with this. Ah, the client crashed. Yeah, that can happen, unfortunately. Although, no, let's... I think I'm gonna go for the safe-ish setup in the middle. And we'll leave our black orcs out alone on the side. And just hope that that's okay. Just trying to decide where to put who. I think we're gonna go with something like this. But I'm gonna put them in behind right away so that I get some blocks in case he decides to blitz somewhere there. And then we'll leave it like this. Sounds like a plan. I think so. So let's confirm that. I never really had that happen to me, I think, that the client crashed in the middle of a game. At least I don't remember if it did. If I had my guard guy, it would be nice. At least I could have put him in the middle to make it a little bit harder on him. He does have enough guard, well, three, to countermeasure that, or to counteract that. But it would have forced him, at least, to do that. But on the upside, now I have three players on the line, which are strength, which have block, and one with strength 4. But looks like he's gonna go with all Chaos Warriors anyways. So it doesn't matter too much how high of a strength I have. Well, arguably. Oh, he's bringing in both of his killers this time. He wants to try for an early player advantage here. Not the worst idea. And considering what he can blitz here, it's probably his best call. He's also setting up very aggressive, so in case of perfect defense, I might be able to really screw him over, because I have more guard. And if I bring all my guard players in here, he's gonna be somewhat screwed. But for that, a perfect defense needs to happen first. I mean, he's got all of his own guard here, but I've got more. Not by that much, but it could be enough. Let's just see what happens. But still, he's setting up extremely aggressively right now. You usually want to stay away from the line of scrimmage with everybody, as long as you can't afford a perfect defense. And you usually can't. Okay, that's fine. Fairly deep kick is good for me, I think, because the way he's set up, he won't really be able to put himself into a cage. He might have to back off in some areas, or just allow me to get past him. We'll see. Okay, starts things with a push, and he will not get another block out of this. So, he did change his setup in the end. He did move his Chaos Warrior over here, so he wants to blitz one of these guys, I assume. But the piling on guy is gonna go for Fork, but he doesn't have a two dice there right now. So he kind of put himself into a bad position with this. These guys don't have block. He doesn't get a two dice because there's no guard in here. Yeah, he was kind of reliant on the first block to actually work to make this okay. Well, even then, it didn't really. So what's he doing here? I mean, this is working. He's not gonna follow. Now he's gonna do the two dice and try to kill me. No, okay. We've got some very lucky rolls here. Three blocks against the line of scrimmage and not a single knockdown. He can block more here, at least one more time. But he shouldn't do that now. He should blitz first and pick up the ball. That also works. Does he want to foul him? Looks like he wants to foul him. That's okay, he's gonna follow that. Okay, there's a stun. That's okay, though. No piling on there, but he's gonna step on him. He should still pick up the ball first, but we'll see what will happen, I guess. Okay, yep, he's at least setting up. Wait. Oh, so he's gonna foul? No? He's not fouling. And that, of course, closes this down pretty well. But I can get past him there. The big question is, how do I want to defend here? How am I gonna blitz? Okay, he makes the pickup. That's not a big surprise, though. So I guess what we're going with is something along those lines. I'm gonna blitz here. Into a push is not good, but it's a start. It's at least for now good enough. I'm just trying to decide where to push him. I think we're just gonna push him back here to keep him next to the Black Orc as well. Now this should be a two dice thanks to the guards. There we go. I'm okay with making that a both down. And now this is a one dice that I can turn into a two dice. That's going to turn back into a one dice again if I don't succeed on the first attempt. So I need to be somewhat careful here. But we'll see. Bring in Awakening to right there. And I think I'm gonna go big on the defense with these guys. So I'm gonna try and get a lot out of this. Put him right there. Yeah, basically I'm just going somewhat all in here. Just keeping Wasted back there. And let's just see what he can do with that. Well, that's kind of a necessary reroll. Into the both down, unfortunately. I can't afford to push him. That would turn this into a one dice because I would only have one assist. So I'm okay with keeping him there. Well, not really, but I don't really have a good choice. And the one dice was just too risky for my taste, considering what I was up against there. Would have been nice. But what is one supposed to do? Yeah, that won't help you. I've got guard. So this is a one dice. If he stands up this guy to remove these two, it's already a two dice. So I'm not sure. Apparently he wants to block him. Which at least right now is... Oh, he wants to blitz him. I mean, that works. Mm-hmm. Makes it. And what do we get? No armor break. Good. He keeps him there, so now this is a two dice. He might do this one. I think he's gonna do this one. Yep, there we go, but he only pushes. Oh, he rerolls into a both down. Ooh, he got lucky there. He's still trying to kill him. So this would have been a good foul setup as well. Luckily, that did not work out. So far, it's a very harmless match, considering the overall matchup. Okay, he gets the knockdown, but it's not nearly as efficient. Might still be good, though. Nope, isn't, though. But I'm still in a bit of a bad position over here. He played that pretty well, so he's gonna move over to here. No, okay, he's keeping it conservative and very defensive, trying to stay back there. Okay, he wants to foul. So this is just an assist for a foul. Nothing else. And this lineman is, or this beastman is going to go here and step on him, I think. I don't really see another reason for him to do that. Yeah, there we go. It's just the foul setup. That's some big commitment to the foul. Didn't get through, though. Still has his bribe. And he makes most of his dodges, unfortunately. Which is kind of a bummer. Let's see if he's willing to risk this one. That one he fails, finally. And there we go. So that obviously helps a bunch. And I'm still... the dodge chaos, exactly. I'm still gonna play this fairly aggressive, I think. Or try to, at least. He's just gonna stand up. So I'm trying to decide where to best put myself. I think we want to try and knock this guy down. Like so, with Mighty Blow. Nice. Okay. That is fine enough, though, because I can push him out there. I'm okay with following, but what it allows me to do is get another good blitz with my piling on player. I'm trying to decide where to put myself. So let's bring Wasted up to here. He will break through to this side if I let him. So we need to stop him there. So there is multiple good reasons to try and stop this. Yeah, let's do this. Come on. Knock down. Good enough. And I'm gonna be greedy now. I'm gonna pile on, even though I didn't get through the armor. I think it's okay. There we go. It's at least a stun, and I can bring... We'll bring what you're looking at right here, because he's still got his guard players, and I need to try and keep these off their feet as much as possible. And then where do I go with you? I have two choices there. Well, three actually, maybe. You know what? Could bring him up here, but he's just gonna dodge away, I think. So I could go here to cost him an assist. But with all the guard around, he won't really do much. So I think I'm gonna go to here. Because he might try to break through this side, and I need him in the backfield to keep this safe. Yeah, let's just see what he can do here. It's kind of difficult to see through all the possible blitz options, but I think I have my guard set up pretty well. He can get a good blitz, and if he can create a kind of a chain reaction through that, he might be able to block a good chunk of my players. Okay, he's trying to aim for that side. Gets the knockdown. Okay, what are we looking at? Once again, no armor break. Oh boy. Yes, okay, that makes this a one dice right now. Because of my guard right there. So he's bringing him over to this side. All of this is still more than okay. It's gonna be a player without block against my block dodge guy. And that turns into a push. So there we go, he's probably... Well, he might want to keep me close to him. This guy does have tackle. Really? He's trying to kill my thrower? I should, most likely. It's not no guarantee, because it depends on everything else. Ooh, risky dodge? Well, not that risky, but... Also not that necessary. So what I was getting at... I want to blitz this guy. Obviously. Now, unfortunately... It becomes a bit more difficult. And that doesn't really help. But it's still doable. That still doesn't help. Also need to do this. There we go, that's better. Okay, because now I can blitz from here. And we can chain push him away. That's the important bit there. Just trying to decide... What else to do first? We probably want to do this block. There we go. Get that situated. Let's not follow. Can't do that one yet because it could fail. I'm gonna bring Orkin to back here. Just setting him up for next turn. And yeah, then we'll do this one. It's the claw guy. The piling on guy, it's gonna allow us to chain push him. Get my thrower out of there. And now I can dodge him. Come on. Still no injuries. This is just the tamest match ever. I think we're gonna leave the Black Orc here, just because it's... I'm actually not quite sure if I want that or not. We can bring him up to here. I should probably move the Black Orc. As a setup for next turn, let's bring him to here, just so that this guy is royally screwed. And then I'm gonna do the weird stuff and bring him up to there. Put a little bit of pressure on his ball carrier that he can't quite ignore. So he's just, yep. Oh, that's a Chi of Iblitz, though. Does he really want to do that as his first action? He shouldn't. Works, though. So let's see if he can kill my thrower. Not that the ammo value 8 is of importance here. Thanks to Claw, it's pretty meaningless. He's piling on there as well, I assume. So this is a dangerous position to be in. Thanks to us being stunned already. And it stays. Really not what you expect out of a matchup. I think I got one injury on him so far, and that was through a foul, maybe? I think so. So this is really not what you expect when you see a Chaos team with at least two Claw Mighty Blow guys, one of them with piling on, and an Orc team with four Mighty Blow players, something along those lines, and one piling on. That's just nothing. And I was about to say finally, but it's just not. It's another stun yet again. So this is a two dice again, but that's a risk I took. He's only pushing me, though. Let's see what this ends up. I don't think he's going to follow that. There we go. I can't really put pressure on the ball as well, though. But right now, my defense is solid, I think. There isn't much he can do. I can't really attack him either, but for now we're good. I am not at player disadvantage. No, we're 11 against 11. If that ever changes, it's gonna be a whole different story. But until it doesn't, or until it does, we're okay. So I'm trying to figure out what to do here. We probably want to start with this one. I'm going to push him and stay, as weird as that might be. This is now a two dice. That's fine, I've got Frenzy. There we go. Come on. it keeps being the stun game. I'm not sure I want to push him this way because of his guard. That's what concerns me here. But if I only push him, he's not going to get knocked. If I push him over here, I'm not gonna be able to knock him down. So I think we're gonna do this after all. We do knock him down. Let's push him back, and I think I'm gonna follow that. So this is still a one dice, and this is a one dice as well. Which means I need more guard right here. Now this is a two dice. Into a push. That's a shame. Gonna put him back there and stay. And now I've got two options. For one, I can blitz here with my piling on. Or I can blitz over here to try and make something happen in that area. I think I'm gonna cover this area because this is where he could break through best right now. I should have done this differently. I should have blitzed from here and pushed him over there. That was a mistake. But we'll see, we'll see. That's a knockdown. Let's put him over this side and follow. Got through the armor, and that's a death. so no piling on needed. And he can't apple that, so this guy is gone. Finally did something. And I'm gonna bring him to here as well. And there we go. It's the weirdest bash match. I mean, it's what happens when you don't kill each other with bash teams. Present killing excluded, of course. There's just, he can't really move forward. He doesn't break, he can't break through my defense because I still think I'm pretty solid there. He's not risking too much. My skill advantage is coming through significantly right now. Because my team value is still 300 higher than his. Even with the two reserve players, that's over 150k in skills, I think. One lineman is 50k. I've got one unskilled one, and the others at least have two skills. So if we go with the cheapest one, would be 90. So 140, so 160 in terms of skills still. And the bench helps as well, of course. I would be down a player already if I didn't have my bench. So this is... yep, okay. Just a push, though. And I was considering blitzing here and moving through, but he could have gotten an easy two dice against this guy then, and that's why I ultimately didn't, just to point that out again. And I thought he maybe could... if he wants to break through, this side would be more likely right now, so I decided to strengthen my defense there while we still have Wasabi over here to try and move him over. Yeah, so I've got all of my guard right here, and that's just... yep, now he's doing one dice blocks to try and create a better position for himself, and that's just not working right now. There we go, that's one down. But as long as he doesn't... that's also not a reposition of his guard. It's just, it's a good block because it worked, but it doesn't help him as much this turn. It just means that I won't be able to block him back as much. And I'm saying as much a lot, I realize that. But that's okay. And now he's starting to move. Yeah, I can see that. See, he's blitzing there. That's just a push. Got lucky. Where is he going to go with this guy? I assume to here or there. Maybe just here. Nope, he's bringing him over there. So now I really need to reposition my players. And I'm going to stand him up. I need to do this block first, just to make my movement as efficiently as possible. I'm okay with this. I'm not gonna pile on. And now I can start to move, so... I think I actually want my strength 4 back there. There we go. These. Okay, that's only one dice. Oh yeah, they've all got guard. Now that's a shame. So the plan was to move him, but that obviously does not work anymore. That's good though. And I'm gonna follow, of course. I think I want to dodge here at the end, but I'm gonna do that at the end. This should be... no, it's a one dice. Okay. Now this becomes interesting, because I need for most of this to work. I mean, a push here is actually okay, I think. We do get the knockdown, though. And I'm gonna follow once again. So there's some issues with this, because this is a one dice. This is a one dice. I have not blitzed yet. Should not forget about that. If we block him, won't be better than a one dice. I think what we're gonna do is blitz here. Even though it does cost me a point of movement, it's another potential knockdown, and it is in fact one. Not gonna follow. Nice. KO. He might still be able to get through with all of this. And unfortunately, I need to GFI here. There we go. That's why I fail. Because if he breaks through there to this guy, it's gonna be bad. Could run away, and now I need to do blocks that I don't want to. So we're gonna do this one first, because there's the 1 in 6 chance for me to fail, and I do. Okay. Now he might actually still make it through. Because of... I should not have done the GFI. I should have just done this. So in an ideal scenario, I would have gotten just a push or a knockdown here, and then would have gotten the two dice because of his guard. That did not work, as we all saw. But that doesn't necessarily mean it's bad yet, because he can't set up a good defense for himself. And I still have some players left to move, even though most of the fast ones are not in a good position right now. Yeah. I think I might have given him a good window here. That's on me. It's still not done yet, but it's not looking too good right now. We'll have to wait and see where he decides to blitz. Mm-hmm. I agree with that. Okay, that also makes sense. But I'm gonna stand firm, so he will have to dodge. So he's not gonna. Okay. Okay, now this becomes very interesting. And what I have planned needs to work. Like this one. Push him to there, unfortunately, and follow. So I've got two options now. I can go with the surf. Or go with a tackle blitz. Because this guy does have... Oh no, can't do that one yet. Need to do this one first. Only a push, but that's okay. I think we want to go with the tackle. So he's gonna go like this, which means he can't go anywhere yet. There's a bunch of stuff that I'm not a fan of right now, but I think we need to do this one first before I move the Black Orc. Let's hope that I don't roll the bad rolls. We do roll the bad rolls, so... What now? Now I roll them again. Well... Nothing I can do about that now, can I? He still needs to dodge, but... this is kind of a bummer. It should not look like this. I gave him the opening, that's on me. But this was unnecessary now. Come on. I screwed up here. I did a good job on defense, and then I screwed up at the last moment. It happens. We're not done yet. Because he can't score this turn. And that's double skulls, so his reroll is gone. Changes it into double pows, though. But still, his reroll is gone. So he's gonna blitz with him. I think. He doesn't want to dodge, so he wants to blitz instead. And if that... Okay, he doesn't blitz with him? Why? Is that a three dice? No. He's just dodging away. Okay. I could also just accept this and serve him. That's a distinct possibility. Don't really want to. Mm-hmm, that's good enough. If he can... What does he do there? Okay, that's a stun. If he can bring this guy to right there, exactly, that pretty much screws me. Yep, and he did. So now I'm not looking too hot. At least he fails that one. I think it's still not impossible to still make this work. It's just starting to look extremely unlikely. So I will have to dodge. And the best I can get is a one dice. Because we're gonna use him. I need to knock him down. And then we can dodge this way and still blitz him. I think that's the only play I have left. If we block him with the one dice, I need to do two dodges instead, but it would be a two dice. Now we're going with this. And this pretty much screws me completely. Unfortunately. Down there. Might as well follow. Yep, he's through. There's nothing I can do about that anymore. That's just done. I can't make these dodges, not without a reroll. It's not worth it, so I'm gonna do the thing to annoy him maybe a bit. Would have liked to serve there. That was the plan at least, but did not happen. So I can still blitz, which means we'll do this. Knock him out. Then I can move back here. And do that block. Ah, well. So he's gonna score. It's gonna be a tie. I don't like it, but can't always get what we want. I know that's not a good argument, but I made the error, and then everything worked for him in the end there, and he was able to shut me out, and it was dumb of me. I have no defense. I admit it. Get that one back. It's his back, so I get one last turn of doing stuff here. So I'm gonna try and get another injury in here or so. But, I mean, we got some SPP. Got another touchdown on my thrower, which I really don't need. Got one injury that gave SPP, and we'll see where the MVP lands. Hopefully on a Black Orc, but probably not. On Awakening would be fine as well. He would level up. He's close. He could use some as well. Well, all the Blitzers. Everybody except a lineman or a thrower would be welcome here in terms of MVP. Just to put myself closer. But we'll have to wait and see what will happen there, I guess. And I just don't know how to do a one-turn touchdown with movement 6. It's not easy. It's anything but, I think. So I might as well do the weird stuff. And once I'm done with all the blockings, I'm gonna... I'm gonna try to pick up the ball with a Black Orc and throw it with him. Which is not gonna work, but hey, I can at least try. So there we go. Let's see what will happen. So I don't really want that. Oh, he's getting a blitz. Well, that's unfortunate. Yeah, I think in the end it was pretty even match for the most part. Could have been worse, could have been better. That's better. He might reroll it because it's basically the only thing he can do. Nope, he's not though. That's okay. It's not like it's changing anything at all. So, that's gonna come last, though. We are gonna start with this. And just seize what happens. I am gonna pile on now, because it's the last turn. So, no reason not to. Didn't do anything, as expected. Do this one. There we go. Once again, nothing. Got one more here. What will it be? Hey! What a surprise. Nothing. And then I've got the splits left. And that's just a push. Maybe I should have used him as a station to attack, but it's okay. Let's see. Actually made the pickup. That's a big surprise. Let's see if I can throw a ball. I cannot. Aww. It's okay, though. It's a tie, which is less okay. The double one in the end screwed me a bit, but even then it wouldn't have been a secure win for me. I think that was my own fault. And of course, the MVP lands on alignment, as expected. So our nothing changed. Our team value didn't change. My fan factor went down by 1, I think, didn't it? Should have been 1900. Now it's 1890. That's fine. That's okay. So, this is today's match. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you want to see me play more Blood Bowl 2, just stick around. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you will tune in next time. And have a nice day. Bye.